Brother Minister, welcome to the White House. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It was so good of you to accept my invitation. We have work to do. Can I get you anything?
All praise is due to Allah. No thank you, sir. I do appreciate the thought very much. I thank you for inviting me and allowing my security to accompany me here. Your hospitality and tremendous intentions go beyond what I've ever hoped for. All praise is due to Allah. Now that we have finally found common ground to bring about real change, we shouldn't waste another moment of time. I understand that you have considered making my family's book The Secret Relationship required reading throughout the nation.
Yes, sir. I have put it on the front burner and it is blazing hot. I read the book and I must say that the truth is there for any fool to understand. Plain as day. I am also aware that you have forwarded your family's great book to many leaders with a letter of friendship, yet it has been ignored. Well, that's all gonna change soon. Very soon. Indeed, I have joined forces with the senator who has selected on a preliminary basis 5 leaders to attend board meetings and discuss the truth. Their first job is to read the book The Secret Relationship, and I have challenged them to read it and see if they can find any lies anywhere within its pages. Since they are the father of lies born with the affliction of lying, they beyond anyone else should be capable of spotting lies quickly. I personally read the book. I did not spot anything in it that appeared to be a lie. I found nothing but the truth. I was shocked at some of the things that have taken place over time. The nerve of these liars, these crooks, these reprobates, these greedy mutts. My God, what they have done. I did study black history and was amazed how much of your information of truth was not being taught at the level necessary to make an impression. That's going to change. I would like to learn more about this affliction of lying and hate that Caucasians have toward the darker races. It boggles my mind. I also read the book The Ice Papers, and apparently there are differing opinions that exist that must be cleared. There can only be one truth, not 2 or 3 or 4, only one. The subject in the book deals with the creation or appearance of the Caucasian on the planet. We need to affirm the truth on that matter since there is so much confusion.
The book, the message explains our point of view. It is what the believers have embraced and what I have embraced. The religious word has been tampered with by the Caucasian.
Senator Kane has been telling me about their affliction. He has informed me that Caucasians must lie a certain amount of time during the day or they can get sick, very sick. He's taking injections of truth that has been slowly transforming his lying habit, allowing him to admit the truth. He knows their time of rule is just about up. And he realizes that telling the truth, making the black man whole and forming positive alliance is the way to go.
The Caucasian has lied his ass off. We all know they colored Jesus white, doctored and interpolated the Bible, diluting its purity, just like they've done to the ocean, the prairie, grasslands and everything else they touched and so-called discovered, things that were here long before they got loose from the cave. They have stolen and ruined everything.